Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Wow, thanks for coming into my kitchen.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Look, I just made a video, and after I made it and processed it and put it up online, some of you noticed that at a certain point, the camera went off focus on my face. Now, how did that happen? Well, I want to explain to you how that happened because I do get a lot of emails, comments and questions where the same thing happens on their 80D and the 70D. Basically, it's the movie mode of the dual pixel focus. So I did a little research to find out how I can replicate that problem because I normally don't have it. So I must have done something and I found out what it was. Bingo! It was in my coffee all along. Yuck. It's cold. So anyway, I'm going to show you what happens. I'm going to show you two ways. First, this is the normal way that I do videos. I set up my light. I've got a hair light behind me. I've got a softbox in front of me. I got the regular kitchen lights on. I used the Better White Balance, the tool that I sell on petergregg.com to white balance the camera. I set it up to 30p, shutter speed 60, f-stop 1.4. Now, I lowered the f-stop to 1.4 and the ISO here because I want it to be seen when the camera's in focus and when it's not out of focus. Here, let me get something. All right, here's a Lipton soup box, okay? Now, when it's with my face, you should be able to read this clearly. Now, because it's 1.4, a little bit forward, if it loses my focus on my face, you're going to see the Lipton box go out of focus tremendously. So let's say I was doing a kitchen thing, and we're going to make barbecue ribs today in my pressure cooker, which is no longer on the counter. Okay, I cleaned the counter. So I would go over here, I would turn the water on, and because I've got a lav mic on, you get to hear all the water dripping, you get to see the back of my head. Now you're going to see what is it trying to focus on until I turn around and come back in. And then you'll see where it grabs focus. Now that's dual pixel focus. It gives me a confidence that is very solid. So if I lean forward like this and move to the left and move to the right, okay, the camera will stay in focus. Now remember, you can watch that Lipton T-Box. Now this is what I did on the one where I made chicken and rice, okay? I'll be right back. And zoom, I'm back. Okay, that's the magic of me walking over and turning the camera off and turning it on. Now what I did is I checked my volume levels, and in the process, I tapped the LCD screen. And this time I paid attention. Where I tapped was in this area here. So if I come stand over here, you'll see that I get much better in focus. But if I walk over here, the camera is going to grab focus over in this area where I tapped. And the first time I did it was by accident. So rather than it's fighting now between the camera's thinking, I'm thinking out loud for the camera. Should I focus on Peter's face because I have it set to autofocus face detection? Or should I focus where Peter tapped, which was accidentally over here? Now the camera is fighting that back and forth. Now you see the Lipton soup box? No good, right? All right, now let's go back to the old way and I'll be right back. And like magic, I'm back in the frame. Okay, so what I did was I reset it. So now autofocus, a dual pixel focus is now the priority is on the face because I did not tap anything. I just reset it and turned it on and came right back here. So now you'll see that the Lipton soup box is in better focus. I'm going to bring the camera over here and I'm going to show you exactly what it's done on the back of the LCD screen. I'm going to use the LX100, which is a Panasonic, and I'm going to put the 5D Mark IV over here. And I'm going to show you the back of the LCD so you can see the mistake. Now, if you already understand what I'm saying, you're done. But if you want to see, I'll be right back, and the Lumix will be the main camera. How do you feel about that? It's excited because it's the main camera. Okay, so let's go get the Canon over here. All right, here we go. Now, let's see if I can do a good job explaining this. Okay, if I tap here on that red cup is in focus. If I tap on that unit right there, that's going to be in focus. So now, if I put my face in there, that spot and that spot is going to be overridden past the face detection focus. So what I need to do is I need to reset it so I only have a blank square there. But if I come into the picture and I sit right here, the camera is going to lock on my face because face detection is now the priority because we started with the big square box, the big white square box. Now, if I tap over here, that area is going to come into focus and it's going to stay in focus. Okay. Now, let me go sit in the chair and see what happens if now that we've tapped on the pressure cooker, it wants to trace and follow the pressure cooker. However, if I move forward, or even if I replace the red cup and get it out of the picture, get rid of the little champagne bottle. Okay, now you're able to see the white square. Where is the white square going? Is it following my face? Or is it doing an attempt to go on the background? Okay, now what happened was I had tapped the screen by accident, engaging the tracking. Okay, now we've got a white square here. You notice the white square? Okay, I hope you could see that. Now that means if I go in there, it's looking for something that looks like a face, whatever its algorithm is. Now that's designed by Canon. It's got nothing to do with me. If I put my face in there, it should grab onto my face before it grabs onto anything else. So by me sitting here now, I can get a book, I can read it to you. I can actually turn and take a look at the pressure cooker and then turn back around. Now I'm set to F1.4. So 1.4 means it's a very shallow depth of field. So that's how the dual pixel focus works and one overrides the other. If I tap on this cup, like right there, now we've got problems. Because if I come into the frame, it may decide to follow my face and it may not. That's up to that because I gave it a priority to follow that cup. Now, if it sees a face before it sees a cup, that's the algorithm of the Canon. So the point is you want to start with the big square, not the square, rectangular box, because I've been calling it a square and I should have been calling it a rectangle because it's basically going to look in that white area and look for a face and it'll track my face whether I go here or here and you can see exactly what's happening. Now if I leave the frame, it's going to go and it's going to revert back to the red cup because I tapped there. Now I want to get rid of that. I want it to be on the lookout for a face, so it's going to go there. So now that we have this rectangle here, even though I have called it a square, now that we have this rectangle here, it's hunting for a face as its top priority. Okay, so that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
Can you give me this foot? Good boy.